Welcome to Acts Christian Church, where you're the head and not the tail.
The year of
Father, in the name of Jesus, we come before your presence this morning on behalf of those who are sick. Almighty God, we present to you, Lord Jesus, your people, aching, Lord, with different illnesses in their bodies, maybe mind and spirit at the moment. Father, we commit your people into your hands, Almighty God, because as your word declared that by your stripes we are healed. And Father, we take authority over every sickness. We take authority over diseases through the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. And we decree and we declare healing. Healing in the bodies of your people. Healing in the minds of your people. Healing in the hearts and the spirit of your people right now, God. We declare and we decree that by your stripes we are healed. Father, let your healing virtue flow through each and every person hearing this prayer right now and in need of healing. Let healing flow, Almighty God, from the crown of their heads to the sole of their feet. Let them feel your supernatural hands at work in their bodies, in their minds, in their spirits, as your healing virtue flow right now, God. We decree and we declare it that by your stripes we are healed, and we claim our healing right now under the authority of your Holy Spirit and through the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. And we thank you for healing, Lord. We claim it and we decree and declare it's already done in Jesus' name. Amen.
Welcome you to Acts Christian Church today, and I want to invite you to come into our live worship service as we lift up the name of Jesus. And I want you to always remember, you're the head and not the tail.
You're lifting up your holy hands and just giving God the highest load of praise, because he has brought us through and taken us a mighty long way. Overseas, I want you to stop for a moment and throw your hands up in the air and to know this is why Jesus loves us. Be blessed. Come on. God is moving in our service today.
I don't know why Jesus
beloved, through it all, Oh, my days. Oh, I'm sure you feel the power of God right where you are right now. You know what? I'm sorry, technical team, but this has to happen. If you can give me 10, put 10 people, if you can put 3 in the chat right now, we'll play that again. Put three. I just need 10 of you to put 3 in that chat. We're going to play that song again right now. I don't know why Jesus loved me. Oh, good morning, beloved. Come on. 10 of you, if you put 3 in that chat, we're going to play that song again because you know what? He is faithful. Oh, hallelujah. We just need it. I want to hear that song again. I don't know why Jesus sacrificed himself. Oh, I'm so glad. Are you glad this morning? Let me know. I just need 10 of you to put 3 in that chat. We've got enough in this congregation to play this song again. I'm so grateful to God that you could be with us today. But I know something great is going to happen. This is our day of thanksgiving. This is our day of praise. We have 10 in the chat. Oh, you know what? Play the song again. hallelujah. Isn't God good? Oh, I'm sure. I am positive. You are feeling, you are engaged in this service. God is good, beloved. It's so great to have you with us today. We are thanking God for you. We are thanking God that you are with Acts Christian Church. I'm Pastor Lloyd Anthony Hall, and I just want to entreat and invite and encourage you to share. Let's get this thing going. We want this service to be spread. We want people to engage. We want you and your neighbor and those upstairs and those around you to just know exactly what is going on. Please subscribe on YouTube. We're so grateful to God that we have that magic number of 100, that great number of 100. We thank you, all those that have subscribed thus far. Please tell someone else about it. It helps with all this algorithms and stuff. But beyond that, it is a great witness for the Lord. So the last three people that you've touched base with on your phone, why not share with them today? And if they say, man, what are you doing? Just tell them, come and look at the service. Come and engage. Come and enjoy. There's something that's going to happen that's going to change your life. Coming up, we've got our Sunday school. And you're going to really, really, really be enticed with what's going on for that. But before that, we're going to take our notices.
This is the notices for Acts Christian Church for this week.
Televangelist Frederick A.C. Price died following hospitalization for COVID-19. He was 89. Price, founder of the Los Angeles-based Crenshaw Christian Center in 1973. The ministry grew into a global recognized organization. The megachurch televised services, which reached an estimation of 15 million households each week. He also established schools for ministries and formal educations. He was also an author of about 50 books on faith. May his soul rest in peace. Coming soon. Fundraising event, Praise-a-Thon, featuring guest artists in support of our live streaming ministry.
Saturday's menu collection, time between 3 p.m. and 7 p.m. For allergies, please ask. Don't forget to add us on Instagram at Cans Catering. That's CANDSCATERING. We look forward to seeing you all. Love, Sandra and Maxie.
Well,
please, please, please remember, take down, make a note of all those wonderful announcements and notices. We've got great things coming up, Axe, so please be mindful. We're going to continue our service. And you know what? There's a little song that says, don't worry, because every little thing's going to be okay. I want you to gather the children. I want you to gather the household that are around. Make sure you can get around and watch our Sunday school. But before the Sunday school, please, take a listen to this.
Don't worry about a thing. On my horizon, three little birds were on my doorstep, singing sweet songs, melody pure and true. And they said, this message is you. They said, don't worry.
Christian Church Children's Corner. My name is Natasha, and today's story is called Two Miracles. One day, a man named Jairus came to see Jesus. He cried, Jesus, please come and heal my daughter. She's dying. If you would just touch my daughter, Jairus said, she would be healed. So Jesus and his disciples went with Jairus. A large crowd followed Jesus as he walked to Jairus' house. Just then, a woman pushed through the crowd towards Jesus. She had been sick for 12 years. The doctors could not heal her. The woman believed that Jesus could heal her. She thought, I know. If I just touch his clothes, I will be healed. As the woman got closer to Jesus, she reached out and touched him. She was healed at that moment. Jesus stopped and turned around. Can you see the hand there as she's about to touch him? That's the woman. She looks very desperate, doesn't she? Who touched me? Jesus asked. I felt power go out of me. The woman knelt before Jesus and said, I am the one who touched you. Jesus said, your faith has made you well. Go in peace. You see the lady down there? People are absolutely amazed. Then finally, Jesus arrived at Jairus' house. The people said it was too late. His daughter had already died. Oh, they're crying. So sad. Jesus said, Jairus, trust me. Your daughter is not dead. She is sleeping. Jesus told everyone to leave the house. Then Jairus and his wife went with Jesus into the girl's bedroom. Jesus knelt down beside her bed and said, wake up, my child. Can you see Jesus holding her hand there? And then right away, she opened her eyes and climbed out of the bed. And his wife, Jairus and his wife were overcome with joy. Look how happy they are. What a lovely story. Very nice. Well, that's the end of our story today, and I really, really hoped you've enjoyed it. Something for us to think about, Jesus's miracles. Sometimes when you think there is no way out or that something just will never happen, don't lose faith, because Jesus still works miracles. Have a nice day. Until next time, bye for now.
Didn't that song put a smile on your face? I'm sure it did. And thank you, Sister Natasha, for our Sunday school reading today. Please remember to share this with a young person that you know, or that your niece, your nephew, someone in the family that you think would love to hear that story and indeed that song. I'm sure it put a smile on your face. Well, God is so good that He loves us so much that He gave us this day. And we're so grateful to God that, you know what? We can say, Abba Father. We can raise our hands. Isn't He a good God? Yes, He is. We're going to continue our service, and we're going to take our tithes and offering. Just take a look at this clip.
Okay, maybe we need to go over this one more time.
Do we have to?
Well, sweetie, I don't know if you're getting a good grasp of the ratios here.
Fine.
Okay, all right, step by step. Before we spend any money, what's the first thing that we do?
Give to God.
Good. And why do we do that?
Because He first loved and gave to us.
Good, 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 good. Okay, great. Now, the second jar here is for so many different things.
Hold on.
What?
God lives in heaven, right?
Yeah, He lives in heaven.
And heaven has streets paved with gold, right?
Streets paved with gold, sure, yes.
So why does He need my money if I don't even have a job?
Okay, all right, so good question. So basically when we give to God, we're giving to the church.
So the church gives the money to God?
No, the church keeps the money.
Oh, does God know about this?
Yes, He basically built the system, yeah.
Okay, good.
Okay. See, sweetie, as you grow up, there is nothing better than giving back to God. In the Bible, it's the only place God says, test me on this. When it comes to your money, He says, test me. It's almost like He's saying, I dare you. And your mom and I, we do just that. Even when things are tough, we always give the first part of our money back to God. And then the church takes that money and does all kinds of things to make God famous, like camps and mission trips and even VBS that you love so much, and even helps out people that are in need. You can't outgive God. And when God says test Him and you do it, He will come through every single time.
Okay, Dad, I get it. I do have one question, though.
Okay.
Why do we need to test God if He already knows all the answers?
That's good. Let me just retrace my steps here just for a minute.
Now, we have the opportunity to give. We have the opportunity to show our love, our gratitude, and our thankfulness to our God. Isn't that great? Especially on a day like today. We have a declaration here at Acts Christian Church, and we'd love for you to take part in our declaration. Something that we say before we give unto our God. So share this message, yes, but also take part with this declaration. It goes like this, and the crew will help me today. God loves a cheerful giver. As we give this tithe and sow this offering, we rebuke the devourer according to Malachi 3:11. For we trust in God and have expectant hearts for what He can do in us, for us and through us as we give thanks for jobs and better jobs, better hours, more money, contracts, creative ideas, wisdom and witty inventions, sales and commissions, raises and bonuses, checks in the mail, gifts and surprises, finding money, bills paid off, debts demolished, royalties received, promotions and properties. And I will give more to the work of the gospel. Is tithe and offering time? Hallelujah. Is tithe and offering time? Hallelujah. Here's the crease. Tithe and offering time. You say it now. Hallelujah. Please, just follow the instructions on how you can give at this time.
How to give by bank transfer. Our account number is 03101928. Our sort code is 309607. How to give online through our donor box. Simply go onto our website and click the Giving tab. Then scroll down to the bottom of the page where you should find the link to our donor box. That will take you onto this page. Simply type in the amount that you'd like to give, for example £10, then click Next. Enter your first name, last name, your email, your address, and your postal code. Then click Next. Then enter your long card number, the expiration date of your card, the security code on the back of the card, your billing postal code, and then donate. And it's that simple.
Hello, I want to welcome you on Acts Christian Church live streaming. I'm Dr. Jerry Grillo. I'm in North Carolina, and I want you to get ready and get postured to receive from Bishop Mark as he brings the word of the Lord to you today. I want to welcome you watching all over the world, and I want to prophesy that a covenant 19 anointing will come on your life, and it will rebuke the COVID-19 virus that is in the earth right now. I want you to get ready. God's about to move. There's an outpouring coming, and the kingdom of God is taking back the cities.
Your preacher for today is
I just need to give God thanks because He spared my life to see another day. I hope you've been blessed throughout our service. It's been amazing just being here, watching the atmosphere, and seeing how you have interacted with our service. We want to give God thanks for your life. All those that work behind the scenes to bring service in this pandemic to you. We pray you're blessed. We want to thank you for continually supporting us on this journey. We pray that your hearts are touched. Well, look, time is going away, and I want to give you my personal testimony. As you know, I was tested positive for coronavirus. My daughter took me to the testing center. She took a test, I took a test. She was negative, I came out positive. And I couldn't believe it because days before, I just felt very tired. I felt as if I had a fever. I had headaches. And when it was confirmed, it gave me a fright. And so I was confirmed. I was placed in my bed for over 10 days. And I began to think, because all the pictures that we've been seeing of individuals who have died, and God rest the soul of our dear beloved great pioneer, Frederick Price, who died of the same condition, COVID. And I think it's important for me to share how the Lord has brought me through. Every time we watched our TVs, we saw the ventilators, people grasping for breath. And I said, Lord, I don't know, But Lord, my life is in your hands. I want to take this time to give God the highest note of praise, but also to give God thanks for my brothers, my sisters, biological people who rang me and encouraged me, my pastors. They called and they sent their texts. And even though that the ministry was told just to give me a chance, you broke protocol. But I'm going to tell you right now, there were people that called me. There were people who texted me. And most likely people text me every day and finding out how you're doing, Bishop. Came to the point where I even got texts that says, you know, God's not going to kill you or take you away at this moment. You got too much to do. And you know, that kind of gripped me as if the enemy wanted to take my life. But I want to give God thanks for the First Lady. Every day up and down the stairs with my breakfast, lunch, and dinner. It came to the point I was saying, love, you can't do this. And she would say, no, for better, for worse. I want to give God thanks for her life, for holding me, praying for me, and supporting me. God bless you, First Lady Lorraine, for your support. But something happened one particular night as I lay on my back looking at the ceiling. Because my breath was taken away from me. I couldn't breathe. And if I walked 1 to 2 steps, I could feel as if my lungs was collapsing. I just couldn't understand it. But the thing is, although I occasionally would be asthmatic, I understood what was going on. But this was worse. And every day I laid on the back and I looked into the ceiling and said, Lord, let your will be done. If I told you that I wasn't afraid, I will be lying in front of you. But I said, God, let your will be done. Every day on my back, I would face the ceiling. But something happened one night, and I'll never forget it. And I told Lorraine, and this is the first time I'm sharing it on this platform. I found myself lying on my back, and all of a sudden, as if I heard, as if it was a zip, zipping down the center of my chest. And I felt that there was somebody pulling things out, clearing things out of my chest. My chest was open. I felt, and there was a work going on. And I just stood there. I couldn't do anything else as I lied on my back. When the work was done, I was finding myself breathing in, breathing out. And I said, God, this is you. This has to be you. And I fell asleep. Soon as I woke, I told Lorraine the dream. And I could see that even if I walked, I wasn't breathing as heavy. I was recouping. I said, God, you are incredible. But I want to tell God, I want to also want to thank God, even for my sister that made the Corona juice. But God did a work on my life, opened my chest, and was pulling things out as if to say, listen, this is your season. If I had to put a theme on this, the theme would be for everyone. It's time to face the wall. Wow. You better write that down. It's time to face the wall. The Bible reminds me of one thing, which is the story of Ezekiah. He was at death gate. You can find this in the 3 books of the Bible. You can read it in 2 Kings 20, 2 Chronicles 33 to 24 to 26. And you can also find it in Isaiah 38, 39. But that's where I want to go. I want everybody right this moment to look at it. Time to turn your face to the wall. Hallelujah. Turn your face to the wall. Now I want you to understand where I'm coming from on this message. that is personal to me. There are 39 kings of Judah and Israel. And out of the 39 kings, only 8 were good. And that also included King Hezekiah, was one of them. King Hezekiah was about 38 years of age. He had won a famous battle over the Assyrians. But I want you to get ready for this. I want you to look at this scripture as you read it from Isaiah, hallelujah, 38, verse 1. It says, in those days, Hezekiah became ill and was at the point of death. The prophet Isaiah, son of Amos, went to him and said, this is what the Lord said. Put your house in order, because you are going to die. You will not recover. Verse 2 says, Hezekiah, oh God, Hezekiah turned his face to the wall and prayed to the Lord. The verse 3, he said, remember, Lord, how I was walking before you faithfully and with a wholehearted devotion, and have done what is good in your eyes. And Hezekiah wept bitterly. Watch this. It's time for us to turn our faces to the wall. Then the Lord said in verse 4, the word of the Lord came to Isaiah and said, go tell Hezekiah that his prayers, go and tell Hezekiah, this is what the Lord, the God of his father David, said. I have heard your prayers and seen your tears, and I will add unto you 15 more years to your life, and I will deliver you and this city from the hands of the kings of the Assyrians, and I will defend this city. This is the word of the Lord. And a sign to you that I will keep my promise. Here's where I want to go. Time to turn your face to the wall. Even at the time and the situation in which we are living, we need to turn our face to the wall. Watch this. May I suggest to you, the reason we turn to man instead of the wall is because of our situation. What we're going through, instead of we turn to God, turn to our wall, we tend to turn to our situation. We tend to turn to our doctors. We tend to turn to our consultants. We turn to our finances. We turn to our investors. We turn to everything except our wall. Hallelujah. Where we can focus on God. Watch this. I truly believe that day that in the palace where King Hezekiah was, he had his advisors. He had his sympathetic relationship and relatives that was watching and saw. He had in the room the priests as well. And even in that place, he also, in his palace, he must have had the prophet Isaiah. But what? The Bible says he turned his face from his sickness. Oh my God. He turned his face from his sickness. He turned his face from his body, his physical pain, and also the very friends that was around him. He turned his face to the wall. He had advisors in there. He had priests I submit to you, everybody was in the room with Hezekiah, but he turned his face away from them and faced the wall. Oh my God. He turned his face towards the wall to avoid any distractions. There are times in our lives that we need to turn our faces to the wall so we can turn away from any distractions. Now, let me tell you this as I wrap this up. Many of you, I had a teacher by the name of Mr. King. And then when little Mark Nicholson was distracting others, he would say, Mark, come up here, turn yourself to the wall. Look at the wall, stand at the wall, come on. If there's anyone that's been where I've been as a child in school that stood in front of a wall, please put something in the box. I did. And sometimes we ask ourselves the question, how humiliating it is. Why am I standing at the wall? But because we were part of a distraction, because this distraction was distracting us, we had to be pulled away from the distraction and cause us to look at the wall. I said, my good God, I cannot understand now why it was that I had to stand at the wall when I was distracting others. And you know what? When I stood at the wall, it was like a self-consciousness that came to me that I had to focus on myself, focus on the things that I was doing wrong, focus on the things that was going to move me to the next level. I've got a message here to tell somebody. It's time that you turn to the wall. Forget about your finances. Forget about your investors. Forget about the consultants. The Hezekiah's breakthrough was because he turned to the wall, and at the wall he saw his God that was saying, you know what? You prayed a prayer that's touched my heart in such a way that I'm going to give to you 15 more years. Turn yourself to the wall. Sometimes you need to go quiet. Sometimes you need to take yourself away from the madding crowd. Sometimes you need to isolate yourself. Sometimes you need to turn your phone off. Sometimes you need to get off the internet, because God wants you to turn yourself towards the wall, that you can see him and him alone. I feel the anointing of God. The wall will help us to reflect on ourselves and stop us from getting everybody else involved and in trouble. It's time to turn to your wall. In this heat of pandemic, we were worried, and I was worried, and I was concerned, and I didn't even engage in anything happening in the ministry. What's up? I just kept myself and said, God, all I want to do is to look into your beautiful face. Yes. I said, God, you haven't brought me this far to leave me. This is not my portion. But God had me to look towards the wall. Is there somebody out there this moment, distracted to the point that your advisors are telling you what to do, your consultants, your doctors telling you, he wants you to turn to the wall. Turn to him. Come out of anything that is distracting you at this moment in time and hear what God has for your life. It's time to face the wall. Hezekiah knew he was sick unto death. And then Isaiah comes and tells him, you're going to die. What a double whammy. But Hezekiah made sure he turned his face to the wall and said, God, you got to remember when I praised you and gave you thanks. And the same message came back and told him that God was touched by his prayer. I want to encourage you as I close here now. It's time to turn to the wall. Turn to the wall where you will not be distracted. You will not be misled. You will not be misunderstood. Turn to the wall. And let me finish this. There are times we used to be turned to the chalkboard. And we used to write on the board, I will not do this, I will improve. Sometimes God wants to speak to us as a vision, as an empowerment word to tell us that you are the head and not the tail. And God wants you to focus as you look at your wall. Can I encourage you right now? Turn to the wall. Listen to God Almighty. You shall live and not die. And you shall declare the works of the Lord. Amen. If you're out there hearing my voice, this is your opportunity to turn to your wall. And when you turn to your wall, this is the opportunity where God will meet you. Turn to your wall. When you turn to your wall, God will give you fresh knowledge, fresh wisdom, fresh understanding. Ezekiah was blessed with 15 more years. You know what 15 more years can do to a person's life? If it's added, you can achieve things that you never believed you would have. But we need to turn to our wall. Stop being distracted and turn to the wall. I want to pray for somebody out there right now. The God has said, listen, I want to bless you beyond your days, but it's time. You move away from being distracted. Turn to your wall. Father, I pray right now who's hearing this word, that this word will speak like never before. Send a prophet to speak into that woman's life, that man's life, to let them know you're going to turn to your wall. You're going to speak to your God and tell him, God, take my prayers of forgiveness. And lead me into another direction. COVID, come against everyone right now in every hospital. Because there is life for a look at the crucified one. Turn to your wall. Don't be distracted. And cry out to God. And God will send down his angel and grant you the desires of your heart. Can I change the mind of God? Yes, if my heart is right, if it's sincere, if it's direct, you can change the mind of God. For those out there that don't know the Lord Jesus Christ, I want to pray with you. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus that this word will become relevant as they change their position and face the wall and cry out to God and leave out every distraction. Father, if they're not saved, I pray right now that you touch their heart. Let them realize that they're a sinner and can be saved by grace. I pray right now for you now that you open your heart and receive Christ as your personal Savior. I pray right now for salvation to come into your life. Turn you around after you've had an encounter with your personal wall and say, God, I want to focus on you. Let your will be done now. And Father, we thank you for that person who said yes in receiving you into their lives. We thank you. We thank you. Turn to your wall. Focus on what God has for you. Let me pray as we pray out this session. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you. And I thank you for the journey that you've brought me through. I'm alive. I'm alive. Hallelujah. I'm alive. I'm able to shout hallelujah, glory to God. I'm alive. Father. Thank you for the breath that I can inhale and exhale. Thank you, God. Thank you for the wall experience. Fathers, we're about to go. We pray that you go with us. Touch us from our head to the sole of our feet. Let us realize the importance of turning to our wall and moving from distraction to elevation. We give you thanks and we give you praise. In no other name but your name, Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. It's time to face the wall.
More of Acts Christian Church, make sure to subscribe and click the notification bell.
I told you it's going to be a powerful word. We just give God thanks for our bishop. We give God thanks for his life. Please, please, share this word. Someone is going to need that encouragement. Someone is going to need to hear that word. It's just left for me to say thank you for taking part. Thank you for being with us. Thank you for being in this service at Acts Christian Church. Place for change. Remember, you're the head and not the tail. Just take it from me now that as I give this benediction, you are going to have the week of all weeks. May our God give you strength in this week. May our God give you peace in this week. And may our God bless you in this week.
Axe Christian Church, where you're the head and not the tail.